Grace and mercy be upon us all today. Of course, the love of our Father, we continue to enjoy, and the intimacy of the Holy Spirit, which He offers to us on a daily basis, is also a beautiful thing that we ought to every day enjoy and benefit from. We have been talking about the glorious work of the Holy Spirit for some time now, and I believe that many of us are benefiting from it. More and more, we realize that to relate with the Holy Spirit properly is the most important thing that we need to do after we receive salvation from Jesus. Praise God. And for that, we need to continue growing in our understanding. That is why Paul, in his prayer to the Christians in Ephesus, Ephesians 1 verse 17, he says that he keeps on asking the Father, the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, that He may give us the spirit of wisdom and revelation, so that all believers may know Him better. Praise God. Hallelujah. So that's something that we cannot afford to miss. And that's why we continue learning, studying, and of course praying that God will favor us with concrete and personal experiences or encounters with the Holy Spirit. Thank you for today, O Lord, as we take a look again from your word and learn what is it that you want us to know more about the glorious work of your Spirit in our life. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for you. It is you who gives us revelation and wisdom, so we will know you better. Hallelujah. We will know you more. Hallelujah. And therefore, the Father be honored, Jesus be glorified, even in this session. We thank you. We bless you, Lord, in Christ's name. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's take a look again at John chapter 16. John 16, in verses 14, 15, and verses 14 and 15. It says here, He will bring glory to me by taking from what is mine and making it known to you. All that belongs to the Father is mine. This is Jesus talking, remember. He was talking to His disciples at this time. All that belongs to the Father is mine. That is why I said, the Spirit will take from what is mine and make it known to you. Praise be to God. But first and foremost, it says in verse 14 that the Holy Spirit, when He comes, He will bring glory to me. That's what Jesus said. He will bring glory to me. Me is Jesus. And when the Spirit comes, He will bring glory to Jesus. Remember that during this time, when Jesus was speaking these words, He was still physically present among His disciples. But when He was saying this, and when this will start to happen, Jesus will no longer be physically present. Because by this time, by that time, he will be already in back in heaven. And it's the Holy Spirit who was taking over his place. But Jesus was very specific and particular same time when he said that when the Spirit comes, he will bring glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. He will bring glory to Jesus. He will bring honor to Jesus. Even though Jesus would no longer be physically present at the time, but he will be glorious still and honored, worshiped. More and more people will know who is Jesus through the glorious work of the Holy Spirit. So what will the Spirit do in order to bring glory to Jesus? The answer can be taken from the last portion of the verse. Jesus said, he will bring glory to me by taking from what is mine and making it known to you. How will the Spirit bring glory? By taking from what is mine and making it known to you. He will take what belongs to me and he will reveal them to you. Reveal them to the disciples at the time. And Jesus explained it a little bit more in the next verse. All that belongs to the Father is mine. Praise be to God. Remember, Jesus is the heir of everything that the Father has. Amen. And then, the church, the Christians, the disciples, followers of Jesus, are co-heirs with Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. So he will take what belongs to the Father, because all that belongs to the Father belongs to Jesus. And then what the Spirit will do is he will make it known to you, to the disciples, to the church. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. Well, this is a very beautiful, but at the same time profound statement by Jesus Christ. Because the effect of this will be that it's not only Jesus who will be glorified, but the church as well will be glorified. Amen. When the Holy Spirit will start his work, you know, the work of taking what belongs to Jesus and showing them to the church, you know, what will happen? First, Jesus will be glorified. Hallelujah. But another beautiful thing that will happen is that the church will also be glorified. Why? Because the church, hallelujah, is the body of Jesus Christ. Jesus is the head of the church. Amen. Another analogy is that Jesus is the bridegroom. And the church is the bride of Jesus Christ. They are into a relationship, covenant relationship. Marriage, which is a covenant relationship, is a type of the relationship that Jesus, hallelujah, you know, established with the church. Praise God. In the same manner that the head and the body analogy is also a relationship, a deep, strong, intimate relationship that Jesus wants every believer to understand. You know, when you have repented of your sins and put all your faith in Christ Jesus, hallelujah, you have become a part of his church. You are now the church of Jesus Christ, part of his, you know, body. He calls you his body. You belong to him. He is now your head. Hallelujah. And you have become an integral part of the Lord Jesus Christ. So that when the head is glorified, the body is glorified. Praise God. When the groom is glorified, the bride is glorified. Praise God. Because, as already explained by Paul in Ephesians, between the husband and the wife, you know, in marriage, that two becomes one. Also, Jesus amplified that in Matthew chapter 19. They are no longer two, but one. They are no longer two, but one. He was referring to the man and the woman who has entered into marriage. They are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Again, let me repeat. When Jesus is glorified, the church is glorified with Him. Hallelujah. When the church is glorified, Jesus is glorified as well. Because Jesus, hallelujah, claims oneness with His church. Praise God. Hallelujah. How beautiful and powerful this is, my brothers and sisters. That's why you and me need to reflect this again and again. Think about this as the glorious work of the Spirit to help us get a revelation of this wisdom and revelation of the beautiful relationship that ought to happen, which we ought to enjoy, which we ought to manifest. Hallelujah. This should be the basis of our work, our service, our ministry. When we serve the Lord, we are serving because we are in a relationship with Him. Amen. Huh? It is not something that we are coerced to do. It should be an outflow of our love relationship with Him, of our connection with Him. It is His life that is sustaining us. It is His joy that giving us the strength, hallelujah, to do whatever He wants us to do. Praise be to God. All that belongs to the Father belongs to Jesus. And everything that Jesus has, the Spirit will take, hallelujah, from what Jesus has and make it known, hallelujah, to the church. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. He wants to make known to you salvation. Praise God. The meaning of that, the benefit of that, the effect of that in a person's life. He wants to make known to you every other kind of blessing that He possesses. Hallelujah. Because all that the Father has belongs to Jesus. And everything, hallelujah, Jesus, He makes them available unto the church. Praise be to God. When it says, make it known to you, remember the word know in the New Testament especially. You know, it means experience. Praise God. That you will have an experience of everything that Jesus has. Praise God. That you will be partakers, you know, of all those that the Father has, which Jesus also claims to possess, that all this belongs to Him. That is why, my dear brothers and sisters, you know, when we continue to reflect on these things, on these truths, and ask the Holy Spirit to help us understand, you know, more and more our connection and our relationship with our Father, to His Son, Jesus Christ, will deepen. Praise God, and will become even more strong, praise God, so that there will be an unbreakable bond between you and the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why Paul, in his letter to the Christians in Rome, you know, in Romans chapter 8, you know, he was able to say this. We read a portion of these verses actually last time. In Romans 8, verse number 37 up to verse number 39. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. Why are we more than conquerors? How could we be more than conquerors? The answer is through the one who loved us. And who is this one who loved us? Of course, God our Father in heaven. And Jesus Christ our Lord. Praise be to God. So, it says in the next verse, 38, I am convinced, this is what Paul saying, you know, expressing his conviction, I am convinced that neither death, nor life, neither angels, nor demons, neither the present, nor the future, nor any powers. Next line, neither height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Praise God. Imagine that. Look at the last line. Nothing will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Nothing and no one. No situation, no circumstance, no person, human person or demonic entity. Nothing shall ever separate us from that connection, that love that God has shown us in Christ Jesus. All these metaphors, no? Metaphors of groom and bride coming together in marriage, the metaphor of the head and the body being connected are two beautiful metaphors, pictures that will help us realize how close we are supposed to be and intimate with our Father in heaven. And all of this is possible because of the work of the Holy Spirit. Praise be to God. Remember, He comes to glorify Jesus. Hallelujah. He will take everything that the Father has. And everything that the Father has belongs to Jesus. Jesus Himself said so. Amen. And He makes this available. Hallelujah. For all believers to know, to enjoy, to experience, to partake, to be blessed, to be equipped, to be conformed to the image of the Son, etc. and etc. So, when you look at your situation today, and you kind of notice that you are far away from what the Scripture is talking about, there is less glory in your life, then you should not feel sad. You should instead be encouraged. Because what you need to do is to draw closer to the Spirit. Relate in Him. Relate with Him. You know, come to Him. Talk to Him. We've been teaching you simple steps. Acknowledge Him for who He is and why He was sent. Ask Him. Communicate with Him. You know, tell Him what you desire. Hallelujah. And then listen. And then allow Him. Allow Him to work His glorious work in His life. Hallelujah. We look at another of Paul's letters in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20 and 21. This is what we, you know, can read. These are very important, powerful declarations from God's Word. Now to Him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine. Praise God. God is able to do more than all we ask, more than all we can imagine. And how is this possible? The answer is according to His power that is at work within us. Now, who is this referring to? None other than the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit who resides inside this is the power of God. He is the power of heaven. Hallelujah. And that He is at work within us. Amen. You may not feel, you know, at times that He is working. There are moments in your life when you feel you are so far away from the Lord and that He is not working, He is not doing anything because it looks like your situation is not changing. But believe that He is always working. Feeling or no feeling, He is working. The Scripture says so. According to the power that is at work within us. Can you tell yourself today, there is power that is at work within me? Amen. Praise be to God. There is power that is at work within me. One of the good things you need to do when you wake up in the morning is you, during your time of devotion, your prayer time, just use these verses, hallelujah, as a way of reminding yourself. While you are confessing this, your ears will hear. Your mouth confessing and speaking and declare that there is a power that is at work within you. Hallelujah. You are not a pitiful person. Hallelujah. Even though you may not have money in your hands, even though you are facing a huge problem, but you are not something to be, someone to be pitied, because there is power that is at work within you, and that is Holy Spirit power. Hallelujah. That's why the next verse says, to Him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus. You know, I was thinking it should be through Him, because this refers, the Him refers to the Holy Spirit. Through Him be glory in the church. Now, it could be that way. It's still, you know, the same. The true meaning has not changed. Be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus. Where is the glory? In the church and in Christ Jesus. It's not only glory in Christ Jesus, it's glory in the church as well. Remember, I was talking that when the Spirit will bring glory to Jesus, He will at the same time glorify the church, because Jesus is the head of the church. Church is the body of Jesus, and they are inseparable. You can only separate the head from the body when you kill the person. For as long as alive, cannot be separated. I mean, it should be that way. So be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus. And for how long? Throughout all generations. Three times. How long? Throughout all generations. How long? Forever. How long? And ever. Hallelujah. My, this is a triple emphasis of a very important truth that every single believer should realize. Through the Holy Spirit, you can live a glorious life, beautiful life. Hallelujah. Because the Holy Spirit, when He is working in my life and in your life, He will bring glory to Jesus. When He starts working, when we partner with Him, and then He gives us things to do. He gives us revelation. He gives us understanding. He gives us guidance. He gives us, you know, direction. Hallelujah. For example, He puts a thought into our mind, you know, to go to someone and do something unto this someone. For example, He puts a thought in your mind to go to a person whom you know is sick. And then once you are there, you pray for that person. Then the person will receive healing. What will happen? That person will glorify Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And because Jesus is glorified, you, who is the church of Jesus, who is partnering with the Holy Spirit, will also receive a fraction of glory without demanding from anyone. Hallelujah. But of course, you know it is not you. You should remember that it is not you. You should always remember that it is the Holy Spirit working in your life. Never you by your own self. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. So again, what the Holy Spirit will do, He will bring glory to Jesus. And how is that possible? By taking from what Jesus has. And then give them to us. Hallelujah. So what Jesus has? Salvation, forgiveness of sin, redemption, deliverance, healing, you know, restoration of broken relationships, healing of memories, you know, peace, joy, gladness, righteousness, the shalom of God, the totality of a good and healthy being. You know, those are beautiful things that only heaven can provide for sure. And that comes possible through the glorious work of the Holy Spirit. So in a way, the Holy Spirit is the deliverer or the dispenser, the distributor of heaven's wealth, which is made available unto us through Jesus, through the Holy Spirit. So when we work in tandem with the Holy Spirit, you know, we put this into practical perspective. When we work in tandem with the Holy Spirit, He makes our life as the dispenser, you know, of beautiful gifts from heaven, so that the world will partake, will be able to partake. The world will also taste, you know, the goodness of the Lord. And by doing so, their hearts will be drawn back to God. to His Son, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. So many people, you know, all around the world are thinking that no one cares for them. They are convinced, they have convinced themselves that they are, you know, the most pitiful person. Nobody cares for them. They are forgotten, you know. That's why there is an increase, you know, of suicide, is even amongst advanced nations. In fact, the more the nations are advanced, the higher the number of suicides. Because money and power and wealth and everything, you know, cannot satisfy, cannot give comfort, cannot give assurance, you know. The more we are high-tech with all these technologies available unto us, the more lonely are the people. Yeah, the more lonely. And as you may notice, the more sin, you know, is increasing. And the more wild the people are, the more beast-like they are in their conduct and behavior. Because life only, we love its meaning, once we find our way back to Jesus through the Spirit. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Hallelujah. I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. How will we understand this? How will this become clear into your mind and my mind? Only through the work of the Holy Spirit. That is why, brothers and sisters, those of us who are ministering, you know, those of you who are leading cells, life group, or house meetings, you know, please always remember that you must rely in the work of the Holy Spirit. Do not do a ministry apart from the Holy Spirit's enablement. That's why you have to pray, you have to spend time seeking Him. You have to also fast, if possible, because that's the only way that the Spirit will have the joy of working in your life and through your life. Praise be to God. I encourage you, we can live a beautiful life, glorious life, peaceful life. You know, we can live a Christ-like life only because the Spirit lives inside us, and He's the one who will enable us and will empower us, because He wants to glorify the name of Jesus through us. You know, the devil will be scratching his hands, seeing ordinary people, you know, low-class people, uneducated people, seemingly weak people, and yet because they have learned to relate properly with the Holy Spirit, who is their helper, they're able to accomplish things beyond themselves. And in doing so, glorify the name of Jesus. They produce powerful testimonies. Hallelujah. Supernatural stories. Hallelujah. Why? Because the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, they relate with Him properly, and they're able to access their heaven's resources and experience them here on earth, and, you know, distribute them to people in need. Praise be to God. Amen. Let me pray, give thanks to the Lord as I encourage you to keep relating with the Holy Spirit. Your life will never be the same once you learn to access the wealth of heaven. We're not just talking about material things here. Material things is secondary. But all that Jesus has, which belongs to the Father, which also belongs to Jesus, He makes them available, you know, for every one of us to partake, so that we will have something to share to this world in need. Father, thank you for your glorious work even now. Hallelujah. Thank you through the Holy Spirit that He will take what belongs to Jesus, which belongs to the Father as well, and gives them to us, so we become first in enjoying them. Praise be to God. But as we enjoy them, we will also share them to others, to the people at large. So many more will come to know who is this Jesus, through the glorious work of the Holy Spirit. So right now, Holy Spirit, let's glorify the name of Jesus. You and me, O Lord, let's together continue this divine partnership so we can glorify Jesus and that many more will know who He is, Jesus, experience His saving grace, His love, His power, His mercy, His forgiveness, His healing, His deliverance, and many more that He wishes to bless the world with. Holy Spirit, thank You for working in my life and through my life and working in the lives of Your people and through Your people. Thank You for raising up men and women all over in every place, O Lord. And I even include praying for other congregations that calls on the name of Jesus, that they too, Lord God, will love and understanding of these things. Let Your church continue to rise in power and in glory. It is a glorious church, hallelujah, without spot and wrinkle, washed by the blood of the Lamb. Thank You, dear Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.